Hello everyone, welcome to China University Alliance. My name is David. For today, I will to introduce about China University Alliance and how to study in China and why do you want us to study in China in the future. Okay, for today we can see about the content here. The first one is why study in China and nowadays China and the scholarship in China and what we will offer. And the fifth one, we will talk about the post-study life in China in the future. Okay, first one, we will to think about why study in China. How about China now? I think first of all, we can to see a number here. Here is a long number and a big number. It looks like a telephone number, right? Okay, so it's too long. It's a telephone number or it's the money or what it is. We can guess. So here is a GDP. It's a 2018 GDP in China. We can read it, yeah? Here is 13 trillion and 457 billion and 267 million US dollars. Here is the 2008 China's GDP. Okay, we will see about this picture. Here is the GDP from the many countries in all of the world. USA, UK, and China, and Australia, and Russia. Okay, China in the past 20 years already became the top two largest economy in all of the world. Of course, the first one is USA, is the highest one, and the second one is China. So we can see how about the GDP growth in the last 20 years in all of the world. Here is the 1988 GDP in trillion, in top 10 in all of the world. We can see where is China? It's no China here. USA, Japan, Germany, France, UK, it's no China here. But till 1992, China became to the bottom one, it's 10th. And 1993, and 1994, and 1996. And here is 2000. China already became to top 5 in all of the world. And we can see 2005 and 2006. Yeah, now China became the 4th. And 2007 is the third one. In 2010, China is already became to the top 2 in all of the world. And here is 2018 GDPs in top 2 in all of the world. Yeah, so we can see China's GDPs, economics, is increasing rapidly in the past 20 years. So we can think about it. If the economics increasing so fast, so it will be effect about the education and the others. Okay, we can to take a tour to have a look about nowadays China. How is it? The first thing, I think we can have a tour in today's China now. Here is Beijing. Firstly, we can see the capital of China. Here is the city center with a CBD in Beijing now. Yeah. And here we also can see the Olympic Games Stadium, yeah. And the second one is also the Olympic Games, yeah, here. And here is the Great Wall. And the Forbidden City, right. And the Great Wall, yeah, everything. So let's see a video about Beijing from the ancient China to till now, okay?
Thank you. 成功。
Okay, second one we will to talk about Shanghai. How is Shanghai now? Here is the Pudong New Town about Shanghai. You can see the light. Yeah. Here is Shanghai. And Guangzhou is in south of China and it's also like a metropolitan. Here is the Canton Tower and with the CBD in Guangzhou, right?And it's Canton Tower and the Pearl River side, yeah. Okay, China also have the other cities. It's like some peaceful cities like Liangyungang, like Dalian is also the seashore city. And Xinan, yeah, it's a Confucius hometown here, right? And here's Kunming. So also have some very peaceful city. But for today, I think we can...talk more about the scholarship in China. We already see the pictures in nowadays China. In part three, we can talk about the scholarship, what you will get. So firstly, I think we can to talk about Belt and Road policy. It's a very, very important policy in China. We can see this picture. This picture is showing about the Belt and Road from Beijing to Xi'an, Lanzhou, and Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and Iran, Turkey, Russia, until Germany and Italy. For this road, it's the Silk Road in the ancient China. It's also the Silk Road with the economic belt. Yes, and also the other one is from the Ocean Road. Ocean Road is like the, it means the 21st century Silk Road from the ocean.From Beihai to Malaysia to Vietnam, India, and Sri Lanka, and Kenya to Greece. So the initiative is largely about building the infrastructure in Asia, Europe, and East Africa, roads and railways, the ports and the airports, the pipelines, and the power plants. But it also takes in other large projects.Such as the education programs and the development of the industrial and the special economic zone. The Chinese constructors are heavily involved all over the world, all of the countries on the Belt and Road, on the Belt, right? Okay, here we talk about the impact of the Belt and Road, the initiative of the education. By the end of 2016, China has signed a mutual recognition agreement.For academic degrees with 47 nations and regions. According to the date released by the Minister of the Education, a total of, here's the number, right? A total of how many foreign students from how many countries study in China. It's also a big number. I already told you, here is over 500,000 foreign students from 196 countries studied in China in 2018. Among which, how many? Yes, here also 357,000 are from the countries along the Belt and Road route. So we can accounting it. So accounting the rate is about 66% of the total number from the Belt and Road. So we can think about, so this policy is very important in the past few years. Okay, we can see,Here is some pictures from the students from different countries, stay in China, and their life. to learn how to using the Chinese traditional tea, right? And with the Chinese caricature, right? Yeah, here is the graduation ceremony for them in China. And here is how they can find a job. You can see here is a career fair for international students in China, right? Okay, in this part, we will talk about the growth trend of international students in China and USA. We can see this form here, the number of international students in China in past 15 years. We can see in the beginning, the bottom one. Yeah, the bottom one is 141,000 students. They came to China for study in 2005. Yeah, this number, in 2005. But we can see the top one. The top one is 500,000 till 2018. So you can see the numbers, they come to China, that is increasing rapidly in the past 15 years in China. Also, we can see the other one is in USA. How many? We can guess the number of international students stay in USA. How many? We can guess. It's also big. Yes, yes, of course, it's much more than China. It's over 1,000,000 students stay in USA. But this number in past 3 years, 2016, 2017, is decreasing 3.3%. And in 2018, it's decreasing 6.6%. And also in past 3 years, it's every year been decreasing the numbers here. So I think we can guess, in the 10 years later, I think should be China will be the most popular destination for students in all over the world, because you can see that this number is increasing rapidly. But in USA, it's decreasing day by day and every year. So what do you think? Think China should be the most popular one? Right, I think so. Okay, next one we can talk about the scholarship for the international students in China. What you can get the scholarship? What kind of the scholarship you will get in the future? So firstly, you can have Chinese government scholarship and even the local government scholarship and the Confucius Institute scholarship. And also, we have some school scholarships here. And enterprise scholarship. And the other scholarships. So, from this one, from this one, from this one. Here, how many here? We have six types of them. And also, for six types of them, what is my job? COA job. My job is 100% covered by COA in the future. My job is cover all kinds of the scholarship for you and help you to study in China in the future. Here is the key enrollment countries along the Belt and Road. It's incomplete. It's a partial of the countries we are already doing the cooperation. Yeah, you can see Ukraine, Kazakhstan, Malaysia, Uzbekistan, and also Romania, Russia, Belarus. Here, yeah, yes, here is a partial. Mainly, most of them are from the Belt and Road countries, but we also extend our business to different areas in all over the world. Now, we can turn on to the part four. What we offer here? What we offer here? The first one, you will see a big picture here. Yeah, you can see a big picture right here. Here is all the logos. It's a partial logos from us. We already signed the contract, and we already did the cooperation with them. The logo of the university. You can see Shanxi Normal University, Sun Yat-sen University, and the Zhejiang University, Northeast University. Yeah, here is the partial. We already cooperate with over 100 universities in China. We signed the contract with them. We will help those universities to recruiting students every year. Here, we also can say the programs we will offer. How many programs we have? We have Chinese language programs, and bachelor degree programs, and master degree programs, and doctorate programs. And even the bachelor degree, master degree, and doctorate, we have two types. You can choose the Chinese taught or English taught. It also concludes 100 majors you can choose here. Right. So from us, we will help you to easily access this scholarship. I already told you here has five types of the scholarship here, the national scholarship, the Confucius, the Belt and Road province, and the university scholarship. So my job is to help you to assess, easy assess, to get it. We are ready to do a calculate from the last 5 years for my students, the students to find us and to help them doing the scholarship application. The success rate is over 97.3% in the past 5 years. So that is means if you find us and we can help you get one of these five. Yeah, of course. Okay, here we will talk about the benefits. What is your benefit? What you will get in the future from us? I think firstly, you can have the high quality education. I think you never heard about, never think about how many universities in China. The number is 2,397 universities in China now. And we have over 22 universities in the world's top 500. So you will have the high quality education in China. And the second one, you can have the international diploma. Because the China university sending you the diploma is authorized by over 157 countries. Yeah. And the third one is a high scholarship. Because your tuition fee, your dormitory is already being 100% scholarship covered. And the last one, you will have more job opportunities. Every year in China, we will have over 13,510,000 new job opportunities every year in China. That is, means you can have high quality education and with the scholarship, which authorized by 157 countries. And if you want to study in China, you also can have more job opportunities here, right? The other one, my services, COA services, is not only one-time services. My services here is one-stop services. I can explain to you what is the one-stop services. For example, the first one, convenient. We will help you to optimize the application process, select a school right fit for you, integrate materials, submit through the internal channel. So it's easily to application. And the second one is customized. The scholarship application will help you apply easily and deliver your offer on time and the visa application. And the third one is upgrade. We have exclusive services such as the pickup service. Yeah, the pickup service is means if you arrived in China, we will help you to pick you up from the airport to the universities and help you to register, bring you to the bank, the police station to have the bank card and register. Yes, and also we will give you a welcome gift. Yeah, and when the summer holiday, the winter holiday, we will offer some internship arrangement. Yeah, and when you graduate in China, we also will help you to find a job here. Yeah, here is the career planning. And the other one is guide. The guidance for life in China. For students who already received the offer, and we will provide them with the free guidance on life and study before they come to China. So we can see all of the four here. The convenient, customized, and upgrade, and the guide. So here is the one-stop services. Okay, now we can compare between China and other countries. How about the tuition fee and the living cost and the total? For example, USA, you will be spent $25,000 to $45,000 for tuition fee, and the living cost is around $20,000. So we can count it. So for total 4 years, normally you will be spent $160,000 to $280,000. It's a big money. It's a huge. UK is similar. It's also around $200,000 for 4 years. Okay, but we can see here. How about China? The tuition fee is around $3,000 to $5,000. and the living cost is from 2,000 to 3,000. So totally, normally you will be spend all 4 years around 20,000 to 36,000 US dollars. That's all. It's really cheap, right? But I don't think so. For this one, it's also big money. 22,000, 36,000 is also expensive. Now we need to say we don't need this one. It can be more cheaper. So if you choose COA, we will help you. You only can spend 4,000 to 6,000 US dollars for all 4 or 5 years you can study in China. You can think about, wow, so it's so cheap here. Why? I told you, because it's 100% scholarship will cover everything. So you only spend this money. It's no more other expense. I think you will be to think about, wow, it's so cheap. How about the quality? I think next page, I will tell you how about the quality in China universities. Here is the number of the top 500 universities by country. We can see here is the mainly country for overseas study all over the world. USA, UK, Australia, Swiss, Netherlands, and China. So here is the mainly countries. So how many universities they have in the top 500 universities? We can see this number. USA, 176 and 167. UK, 42 and Australia, 22. Swiss, 8 and Netherlands, 13. Yes, here is China, 82. So we can compare of the main countries here. China is the top two. It's only less than USA. I know, yeah, of course, USA is the most one, of course. But China is also the second one. So that is means if you study in China, you also can receive the higher level quality of the study, the higher education in China, right? Okay, we turn to the part five, post-study life in China. I think if you want to study in China, you will think about, when you graduate, where should you go? Stay in China or go back to your country? Yes, of course, we have your post-study work in China. We will help you to a career plan. Because you will have the opportunities for young generation here. We can see the data here. Here is the 2019 data here. It's about 500,000 students come to China in 2019. And also, in last year, China already sending over 300,000 working visa to them. So we can count it. Yeah. It's about 70%. They will have the better opportunities in China. This data is from the HSBC. It's correct. So you will have to stay in China, and also you can have your post-study work here, of course. Again, finally, we can to see what you will get. Yeah, we can to review here. You will have your life guidance, your money saving, and over 100 majors, and cozy environment, quality education, and over 50 universities you can choose. Yeah, and the future career, and the pickup service, and 100% the scholarship and time saving. The many important, most important, one-stop services you will have from COA. Yeah, that is, again, what you will get in the future. I already told you, you get 10 of all of the service here. Yes, finally, I will tell you, welcome to China. I will be here waiting for you. Thank you.